Hello, boys and girls, and welcome to Unit 7 Study Guide for Math. We're going to be looking at six different skills you'll need to have mastered for tomorrow's test in order to do well in tomorrow's test. One is comparing values, okay? Greater than, less than, equal to, using positive and negative values. Number two, number sentences. You'll have an equation, and you'll have to tell me if the equation is true or if it's false. Pretty much just checking if it's right or wrong. Number three, inserting parentheses, okay? Remember that we have to follow the order of operation, and we often have to put in a parenthesis so we can do that part of the operation first. Number four, adding and subtracting positive and negative values. Remember that we learned the three-step rule, where you first locate the number, second, face the direction, you either face positive or face the negative direction, and then third, you either walk forward, if it's positive, plus, or you walk backwards, if it's negative. Number five, standard, scientific, and number and word notation. Okay, you'll have a number written in standard form, which is normal, the way you normally see a number. Scientific notation is to the power, it's 10 to the power of something. Okay, and number and word notation is you write one, and then you write the word, you spell the word thousand. Like, you write the one, and the half, the rest of the word is spelled out. And then finally, drawing a line graph. Okay, you will be drawing, analyzing data, and drawing a line graph. All these six skills will be tested tomorrow in the assessment. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started. Comparing values. If we take a look here, boys and girls, you can see that I've written the numbers 0 to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 in the positive direction, and I've also written them in the negative direction to negative 5, so that you can see when the numbers, which numbers are greater and which numbers are less or lesser. Okay, negative 7 would be somewhere down on this end, right? But further down on this end, and 6 is all the way up on here. So clearly, negative 7 is less than. Okay, always remember that the side with the pointy edge is the side that has less. So negative 7 is less than 6. Okay, please pause the video. Remember, pause the video and challenge yourself. And try number 2, try number 3, try number 4, and then check your answer. So pause the video now. Okay, I'm assuming you've already done the questions, so we will continue checking. Okay, number 2 is, we have 1, which is a number, 0.01 is a number in the positive, right? It's a positive number. So, and here we have a number that's negative, way, way at the other end of the negative, negative 32, way down that way. And then 0.01 is somewhere in here between 0 and 1. It's a fraction. It's 1/100th, right? So clearly, 1/100th is greater than negative 32. Over here we have a positive number and a negative number. Remember that this means negative 10 minus negative 10 minus negative 10. When you multiply a negative times a negative, you get a positive. But then with this number, it'll be a positive, positive 100. You multiply times a negative, positive times a negative, and now you get a negative. So it's negative 1,000. So this number right here is negative 1,000, and here we have a positive number. Clearly, 8.5 is greater than negative 1,000. And finally, we have a negative and a negative, okay? And this negative is a fraction. Remember that a fraction is a number between 0 and 1, or if it's negative, it's between 0 and 1 in here. Okay, it's 3/4, so if this is half right in there, okay, if this is half, okay, then we can make quarters as well. The quarter would be here and here, right, because we cut it in half. So this number here is right in there, okay, right in there. But then negative 1.6, it's beyond the 1. Here's the negative 1, and it's almost just over the half this way. So this number is clearly lesser, it's this way, than this number. So negative 3/4 is greater than negative 1.6, okay? Continuing on. For these next questions, you have to tell me whether they're true or false. Okay, so you go ahead and get started. Remember to use the order of operation of PEMDAS, parentheses, exponents, multiplication, division, addition, and subtraction. Remember that these two can be interchangeable, depending on the order from left to right, and these two can be interchangeable, right? If you have multiplication and division, it doesn't matter what order you do them in, they will always give you the same answer. So if you were to do number 15, remember, you can't start by adding 3 plus 7. You cannot do that because addition is after multiplication. You must start by doing multiplication first. You see that? Multiplication comes before addition. So 7 times 5 equals 35 plus 3 equals 38. So this one is clearly true. Okay, you can mark it as true. Right there, true. Okay, go ahead and try 16, 17, 18. Please pause the video now. So let's check. We have over here addition, which is all the way down here, and then we have division, which is over here. So clearly we have to do division first in PEMDAS. So 20 divided by 5 is 4. Negative 5 plus 4 equals negative 1. That is, boys and girls, true. Okay? And over here we have 3, multiplication first, remember before addition. 3 times 4 is 12. Plus negative 2, 12 plus negative 2 is going to be 10. This is obviously not true. False. And then, again, multiplication first. 3 times 4 is 12, plus negative 2 is 10. And this time we have been given the correct answer. Okay. These will be on the test, boys and girls. Very similar questions where you have to tell me true or false. Continuing on. For inserting parentheses, the reason we would do that is in order to manipulate what we do first. Let's pretend that over here you need to add before you multiply. You need to then put parentheses around here because you know that parentheses comes first in order of operation. If you do not put parentheses here, then you will multiply first. Okay, multiply the M, and then add by the order of operation of PEMDAS. So, let's see. If we do not put parentheses, we have 3 times 4 equals 12, plus 7 equals 19. No, that doesn't work. But what if we insert parentheses around the 4 plus 7? 4 plus 7 is 11. Right? And then 11 times 3, or 3 times 11, is 33. And there we go. That's how you would insert these parentheses. Okay, please pause the video and try B and C. Let's see. If we had to do parentheses here so that we can do addition before multiplication, we would have 6 plus 9 is 15, and 15 times 5 is 75. That doesn't work. So what if we did multiplication? 9 times 5 equals 45 plus 6 is 51. Do we need to include parentheses? No, we do not, because we know that we will do multiplication before addition anyways. So we know that we have to do this before we do this. No parentheses are required. C. Let's see over here. 27 divided by 4 will not work. Okay, you're going to get a decimal, and we're trying to avoid that. Let's see if we actually do 4 plus 5 equals 9 plus 6 is 15, and then 15 divided, no, that will also not work. But if we just insert parentheses around these two, okay, we will get 9. And then we know that the next thing we have to do is division. Okay, because parentheses is right here, and then division, and then addition. 27 divided by 9 is 3. Okay, it's 3. Plus 6, the 6 we have here, equals 9. So the parentheses should be around the 4 and the 5.